स्टार्ट
नहीं से मिला। ओके स्टूडेंट, वी विल सॉल्व नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 वी विल सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। क्वेश्चन 8 इज 17 ब्रैकेट, क्वेश्चन 8 इज 17 ब्रैकेट 2 माइनस पी ब्रैकेट क्लोज माइनस 5 ब्रैकेट पी प्लस 12 ब्रैकेट क्लोज अपॉन 1 माइनस 7 पी इज इक्वल टू 8। दिस इज अवर क्वेश्चन, वी हैव टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन। Okay, solution. To solve this question, first we cross multiply and get this. When we multiply this by a 1, this will be same. Therefore, we can multiply, solve this this bracket and this bracket. Okay, 17 to the 34 minus 17 p minus 5 p minus 12 5 60 will be equal to 8 multiplied by this. It will be 8 minus 56 p 7 8 8. Okay, and we will solve this. Okay, now add subtract the variable part and constant part. This is minus 17p and minus 5p. This will give you by adding minus of 22p and 34 plus and minus 60. This will give you minus of 26. This will be equal to 8 minus 56p. And transpose this minus 56p to the left hand side and minus 26 to the right hand side. Okay. This will give you minus 22p plus 56p is equal to 8, and this will be plus 26. And solve this. 34p plus is equal to 8 and 26 is 34. P is equal to 34 upon 34 is equal to 1. P is equal to 1 is the solution of this equation. And now check with the solution. Check. Put p is equal to 1 in this equation. This is 17 bracket 2 minus p bracket close minus 5 bracket p plus 12 bracket close upon 1 minus 17 is equal to 8. Put p is equal to 1 in this equation. We will get 17 bracket 2 minus 1 minus bracket 1 plus 12 bracket close upon 1 minus 7 bracket p 1 is equal to 8. Okay, now solve this. This is 2 minus 1 is 1. 1 into 17 means 17 minus 12 plus 1 13, that is minus 13 upon 1 minus 1 minus 7, that is minus 6 is equal to 8. Okay, this is 17 minus 13, this is minus. Okay, students, we are missing here something, that is here 5. We are missing 5 and calculated according to this equation because of here is 17 and here 2 minus 1 minus 5 bracket 1 that is p plus 12 upon 1 minus 7 1 is good. Okay, this right, and this will be 1 plus 12 13 into 5 that is 65 and this is right. Okay, 17 minus 65 that is minus of 48 upon minus 6 is equal to 8 minus minus plus 6 8 is 48 8 is equal to 8 that is LHS is equal to RHS and this is checked or verified and our answer is right. Now move to the next question, that is question number 9. Question 9 is write question 9 and solve it. Question 9 is 2x minus question 9 is 2x minus bracket 7 minus 5x bracket close upon 9x minus bracket 8 plus 4x bracket close that is equal to 7 upon 6. Okay, now we will solve this equation and find the value of x and then check whether that this value is right or wrong. Solution, to find this solution we will cross multiply this and this. First of all we should solve this bracket and after that we will cross multiply. Okay, here 2x minus 7 plus 5x because of this minus this will be plus x plus 5x upon 9x minus 3 minus 4x because of this minus this will be minus 3 minus 4x is equal to 7 upon 6 and this will solve 2x and plus 5x it will be 7x minus 7 upon 9x minus 4x this will be 5x minus 3 is equal to 7 upon 6 and now we cross multiply this and this. And now we multiply 6 by this 7 6 here 42x minus 42 is equal to 7 5 here 35x minus 7 3 here 21 and now transpose the variable part to the left hand side and constant part to the right hand side. This will be 42x minus 35x is equal to minus of 21 and plus of 42. This is 42 minus 35 and this will give you 7x is equal to and this will give you plus 21 and x is equal to 21 upon 7, 7 3 is 21 and x is the 3. Here our solution is x is equal to 3. Now we will check this whether it is right or wrong. Put this x is equal to 3 into this equation and check whether LHS are equal LHS and RHS are equal or not. Okay, we will write this equation 2x minus bracket 7 minus 5x bracket closed upon 9x minus bracket 3 plus 4x bracket closed is equal to 7 6. It is our question. Put here x is equal to 3 to find the solution. Okay, 2 bracket 3 minus bracket 7 minus I 3 here 15 upon 9 3 minus bracket 3 plus 3 fold 12 is equal to 7 upon 6. This will be 3 to the 6 minus, this is 7 minus 15 minus of 8 upon 9 3 the 27 minus 12 and 3. This is 15 plus 15 is equal to 7 upon 6. This will be 6 plus 8 upon 27 minus 15 is equal to 7 upon 6. This is 7 or 8, 14 upon 27 minus 15. This is 6 plus 8, that is 14 upon 27 minus 15, that is 12 is equal to 7 upon 6. 2 6 to 7, that is 7 upon 6 is equal to 7 upon 6. LHS is equal to RHS, hence it is checked and our solution is right. Now come to the question number 10. We will solve question 10. Our question 10 is 0.4x. 0.4x minus 3 upon 1.5x plus 9, that is equal to minus of 7 upon 5. Okay, we will solve this by cross multiply this and this. We will find 5 4 20, 2.0x minus 5 3 15, that is 7 15, 105 and point is here. This is minus x and 9 7 here 63, minus of 63. Okay, we will take this to the LHS left hand side. This is 2.0x plus 10.5x, this is equal to minus of 63 plus 15. Okay, this will be added to and 10.5, this will give you 12.5x is equal to minus of 48, and this is equal to x is equal to minus of 48 upon 12.5. this is our solution. Okay students, you can also solve this like this, and that is x is equal to minus of 480 upon 125. Point is time to correct 0 1 0. It means this is x is equal to minus 480 upon 125, and 5 figure is from cancelled out. Karte hain, we have 25 denominator, which is denominator minus 96. This is equal to x is equal to 1 minus 96 upon 25. Now check this solution. Check our question is 0.4x minus 3 upon 1.5x plus 9 is equal to minus 7 upon 5. Put the value of x is equal to minus 96 upon 25 and find what happens. 0.4 bracket minus 96 upon 25 bracket close minus 3 upon 1.5 bracket minus 96 upon 25 bracket close plus 9 is equal to minus 7 upon 5. Okay, now we will solve this. We can solve 0.0 and टू टू या फोर, टू वन या टू, टू टू या फोर एंड टू फाइव या टेन एंड दिस विल बी जीरो फाइव थ्री या फिफ्टीन फाइव फाइव या ट्वेंटी फाइव एंड दिस विल बी टू नाइन्टी सिक्स टू या वन हंड्रेड नाइन्टी टू 192 minus upon 125 minus 3 upon 3 6 18 1 3 9 27 and 1 28 288 minus 1 15 plus 9 is equal to minus 8.5. Okay. You can further solve it. LCM. Here 125 is the LCM, and here 190 2 minus 125 3 here 375. Okay, this here we will take 50 LCM minus 258 plus 59 450 that will be equal to minus 5. Okay, this will get you by adding up minus of 7 9 7 16 4 1 5 67 upon 125 multiplied by 50 upon, and this is this will be subtracted by this. Okay. This will be equal to minus R 7.5 and. Then by solving this, you will get minus 7 upon 5 is equal to minus 7 upon 5, that is equal to LHS is equal to RHS and hence Z. Now we will move to the question number. Okay, all exercise has finished. Now we will move next exercise, that is word problem 2.5. Okay students, now we have finished our exercise 2.4. Next exercise is 2.5, that is a word problem. Before solving word problem, we will understand some basic concept. You know that a large number of everyday life problem can be solved by the linear equation in one variable. When we solve word problem in linear equation, first of all, we translate the problem into an equation, and that, after that, we solve this equation to get the value of the variable, and after that, interpreting the solution and write the solution of the problem, and you can check the answer by satisfying the conditions of the problem. Okay, now we will try to solve our next exercise 2.5 question first. Our question is, in here there are two big questions in the word format, so it is not possible to write each and every question in on the blackboard, whiteboard. So we will do the solution of these problems of exercise 2.5 or question first. Okay students, our question first is, the perimeter of a rectangle is 26 centimeter. If its length is 3 cm more than its breadth, find the dimension of the rectangle. Okay, solution. first of all, we consider one quantity. Its length is 3 centimeter more than its breadth. Length is 3 centimeter more. Let the breadth of rectangle be x. Therefore, length will be x plus 3, because it is given in our question that length is 3 centimeter more than the breadth, and the perimeter of rectangle rectangle is equal to 26 centimeter. Okay, student, here we can see that we know the formula for solving the perimeter of a rectangle, that is perimeter of rectangle rectangle is equal to 2 bracket L plus B. It means length plus breadth. And here perimeter is 26 centimeter, that is 2 plus L. What is L? L is R, X plus 3, length plus breadth is X centimeter. Okay. Now we can solve this equation and find the value of x, and that value of x will be our breadth of the rectangle. Okay, 26 is equal to 2 bracket x, that is 2x plus 3. 26 is equal to 2 can be multiplied in the bracket. 2 to the 4x plus 2 to the 6, that is equal to 4x and 26, and 6 can be transported to the LHS, that will be minus 6. 26 minus 6, that is equal to 20 is equal to 4x, and x is equal to 20 upon 4. 4 1 is 4, 4 5 is 20, and x is equal to 5 centimeter. Therefore, breadth of the rectangle, is equal to 5 centimeter, and length of rectangle is equal to x plus 3, that is equal to 5 plus 3 is equal to 8 centimeter. These are the answer. Okay, now come to the question number second. Question second is, two numbers are in the ratio 5-3. If they differ by 18, what are the numbers? ओके स्टूडेंट, हम जानते हैं जब हमारे पास रेशियो में कोई भी नंबर दिए हैं तो हम उनको नंबर में कन्वर्ट कर सकते हैं कोई कॉमन फैक्टर x लेकर के. तो इसका मतलब हो सकता है कि हमारे वन नंबर इज इक्वल टू 5x एंड अदर नंबर इज इक्वल टू 3x. According to question 82, if they differ by 18, you can say that 5x minus 3x is equal to 18. What are the numbers? And you can find the value of x by solving this equation. Here 5x minus 3x, that is equal to 2x, is equal to 18. And x is equal to 18 upon 2, 2 and 2, 2, 9, 18. that is equal to 9. It means one number is equal to 5x is equal to 5 into 9, that is 45. And other number is equal to 3x is equal to 3 into 9, 27. And here we can check this by taking difference of 27 minus 45, and you will get differences of 18, and hence our solution is right. These are the answers. Okay students, in our next session we will solve other questions of this exercise 2.5, and till then you try this question and find whether you find difficulties, and contact me if you have any difficulty to solve this question. Okay, best of luck.